Hey, how about if we do a story on you, Miss Fox 5? Are you Abby?
Like a Facebook Live or something?
Hi, Abby.
Hi, nice
I'm John.
To meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Hi.
Come on in.
Okay, why don't we just take a look first?
Sure.
Can we actually get you making a beat?
With the famous John Dolce.
Here we are in the studio with Abby from Fox 5. We'll be on 10 o'clock tonight, right, Abby?
That's right.
Nice. And this is some of our sample music. This is a 32-channel mixing console.
So you made this?
Yes. That's the video. Yep, I did. It was nice having you, Abby.
Thank you.
We'll see. Right now?
Yeah.
This is Fox 5 News at 10, local Las Vegas.
Empire took on Sin City for its season finale, and coming up, I talked to an industry expert to see what it's like to make music here in Las Vegas.
Well, it's officially a wrap on Empire Season 4, and they certainly packed a lot of drama in for the season finale.
Shoved it all in there. Tonight, we set out to find out if real life lives up to what we see on TV in the music industry. Anyway, Fox 5's Abby Tedros is live on the strip. She talked to music producers.
That's right. I talked to two music producers who make music here locally, and they both tell me that what you see on TV is actually a little less dramatic than what happens in real life. They tell me that they've seen the backstabbing, lying, and abuse throughout the years. One producer in particular told me he used to make and promote music in San Francisco, but had to leave when the drug abuse became excessive for him. He says he got a fresh start in Las Vegas, but won't forget the lessons learned.
Getting into this business, as far as drama goes, sure, you have your setbacks in recording and everything, but once you are fortunate to take the next step and get signed with a major record label, you're actually signing your name in blood. Literally signing your name in blood.
So he says his best advice for up-and-coming artists, don't sign a record deal and try to build your career as an independent artist. He says, yes, it's pricey, but it is worth it. He also says that during his time working as a producer, he was able to work with both Janet and Michael Jackson in the late 80s and early 90s. And that was one of the high notes of his career. He also told me both artists were great to work with. And he says, while there are some lows, there are definitely more highs in this career, especially when it comes to making music and sharing that with people who are just as passionate about it as you. Reporting live, Abby Tedros, Fox 5 News, local Las Vegas.
for the ride. Don't need a reason why. Everything's alright.
Easy boy.
Welcome to our brand new show called Nightbeat right here on Time Warner. I am John Doté, your host, and we've featured this show all over the world. We originally kicked it off from Las Vegas, and we feature the hottest music videos from the hottest music video stars. Music business is the toughest business, as anybody knows, to succeed in it. And I've had my fair share of ups and downs. And thing about music is everybody fantasizes about becoming a star without living the reality of being one. And they have no idea what it's like to be a star. And I know because I've worked with a few of them. And in fact, I brought a picture here of one of the biggest stars that, you know, I ever promoted was Janet Jackson. What have you done for me lately?
Yeah, sometimes I get embarrassed with videos that go that far back. Let's wait a while, what have you done for me lately, nasty? There are certain things that I see that I don't think anyone else truly is paying any attention to, but I really get embarrassed.
Thrilled that you are being honored tonight as an icon. No one deserves this more than you. You have achieved so much and will only keep climbing higher and higher. Your talent knows no boundaries. I love you, and I am honored and proud to be your brother.
Played videos when MTV first started where artists were already established as, you know, radio artists. But there were artists that came up after MTV that really, their whole vision was a visual medium along with music. And
she really made dance videos popular.
She just has this presence that, you know, you're just so drawn to her, you can't keep your eyes off her.
She's a great singer, she's a great dancer, and she's been fighting for what she believes in, and that is music.
And all the fame, she's still the same daughter.
Themes like doing Charlie's Angels and Hawaii 5-0 and everything, the theme era was over with. And it sort of was depressing because so was the fun. So.
If this painting for the new record album, Hooked on Themes, looks familiar, that's because it's the work of fantasy artist Alonzo Smith, who was my guest earlier this year on Creature Features. But right now, let's meet the masterminds, the wunderkinden, behind Penthouse Records, which just released this new album featuring numerous TV themes. Well, first we have John Doté, who has produced records for Capitol, RCA, and Columbia, and who was involved during his long period in Hollywood with the production and recording of many, many TV themes. And this is my old pal, right next to him, Pete Marino, a one-time Hollywood publicity man for Columbia Studios, a former executive for Warner Brothers Records, and soon to be the host of his own Bay Area TV show, Move Over John Stanley. John, what exactly was your involvement with the TV themes?
Actually, I played drums on them. I was a studio drummer, and I also helped with the arrangements and the productions. And I took on themes, and most of these themes that I've been involved with the producers, original producers, and we went into our own studios and we redid them and produced and arranged them ourselves. So.
Very nice. Pete, what exactly is Penthouse Records? What have you done and where are you going?
Okay, Penthouse Records really originated in 1964. We had a hit called I Believe by Dick Stewart. In fact, your director, George Lum, directed the same show that the hit record came off on.
You're really digging the skeletons out of the closet.
Oh, really? Yeah,
you?
Yeah. We had some fun then. So I decided this time I want to put out a first-class album. And the reason we call it Hooked on Themes because right now the two biggest selling albums on the market is one called Hooked on Classics and Hooked on Swing. So I got with my partner, John, and I said, hey, do all the themes that you did from all the old TV series, you know, we'll put it together, we'll call it Hooked on Themes. Mm-hmm. Like, he's the best drummer in the country.
I find show business very fascinating. There's no business like show business. All the great people you get to meet, all the great stars you get to work with, and you're developing your career. Like, my best days were working with Liberace.
Records nowadays sort of happen, you know, and sometimes people get lucky with them and sometimes they don't. But I really feel that, you know, the day of promoting things was very successful, not only for the companies that made the recordings, but for the artists as well. And I kind of miss that, don't you? Because then all the fans would get the bleachers, and yeah. You very seldom see that nowadays.
Were you with us? Seems somehow sadly gay. Gloria, that was wrong. It's of another day. Well, I was terribly alone and forgotten in Manhattan. I'm going home to my city by the bay. I left my San Francisco, high on a hill. On to you, San Francisco, the golden sun will shine for me.
Welcome back, and here we are again with another famous, well-known artist in the San Francisco area. His name is John Dolte, and if I messed up, he's
going to have a little
smack me with. Look
it's
at this
Dolte,
folks. I mean, Liberace, if you're watching.
Eat your heart out, Lee.
I mean, really, and this isn't fake. This is the real stuff. And Mr. T.
Oh, my God.
It's 185-foot long chain.
You know what we should do? Let's Channel 3, let's get together, just mug him and take the he's got a roll sitting outside.
I'd like to announce also A Hero from Zero, which is his latest album. And this is what it looks like. It looks just like what he looks like. It's a fabulous album. We've heard it. You'll be doing the dancer sizes and film clips to it, and lots of the aerobics, and dance, and partying and stuff like that. And he will be singing it live later on.
And we've got to stop meeting this way.
I yes. know, really.
People are going to be talking.
We all
John, just borrow
before
this
we
one.
Say one more thing, we let yes. you get a final word in.
Okay, I'm coming out with a new TV show called John Dolte's Music Videos on one of the channels here in the Bay Area, and Gary and Gloria will be some of my guest hosts on my show. So watch for that.
Where can they see you now? Where
they can see us. Well, they'll have to wait for that video to see us. And watch some cable stations because we'll also be on there doing some videos as well. So John Dote's music video.
And he'll be doing one of his hits later on. What do you mean, shut up? How dare you? He'll be doing one of his songs called Hero from
Zero. And the Wookiee Stomp. All right.
And the Wookiee Hustle.
And Gary's going to show you how to
No, I'm
dance
not going to show
it.
You how to do it.
Yes, he is.
We are going to
and then I'm
going to
take this
on.
Ring. I'm going to borrow
have it.
This ring. Oh, yes.
I'll tell you
take
what.
Take my PG&E bills and everything else.
It was a very rough one, coming from the Bronx, New York, and it was tough growing up. I took a lot of licking, took a lot of punishment, but I think that's something we all go through, you know?
Listen, your new video, what's it called? Because I just got it in the mail and I already busted it on you.
Peace, not greed.
That's right, peace.
Peace, not greed from our second album, High Society, featuring punk legend Jack Grisham from TSOL, the True Sounds of Liberty. One of the original punk bands, started the whole movement. TSOL, Jack Grisham's out singing legendary lyrics from Abolish Government, Peace Through Power, original punk songs from lyrics he wrote back in like 81 and 82, and he's re-bringing them out onto this song, Peace, Not Greed. The video's out now. The album's out now. Came out, everything's popping off. New album, new video will be coming at you soon.
This is Los Angeles.
Lonely teenage daydream of things I just might be. A surreal kind of thinking keeps on drifting in on me.
Good morning, welcome to Night Beat in Las Vegas. I am John Dete, coming to you from the Rock and Roll Review Room, right here from the entertainment capital of the world, Las Vegas.
John is his presence. He just epitomizes Las Vegas. He's an entertainer, he wears a lot of good flashy clothes, and has a good band behind him right now. And so I want everybody to get up to the Royal Casino and hear it. Let's go ahead and play Gypsy Jane, and let's see if we can get John on the phone and get him on the air, and let's talk to him.
Okay, we'll do that. Gypsy Jane with John Dote.
Back, and if you just joined us, you just saw a number by John Dote and dancers Gary and Gloria Poole. They have joined us right now. I'd like to introduce them formally right here. We have Gloria right here and Gary Poole. They are American Bandstand Dance Champions, United States. Welcome to the show.
Brother and sister and single.
Not married.
Well, we'd like to talk about it after the show, huh?
Okay.
No, Gary, why don't you just let me know how you met this guy right here.
This, you really want to know?
Yes.
No.
We were selling gold. No.
Selling gold. They bought us.
And then the following week.
Memorial Day weekend, by the way. Yeah, Memorial Day weekend it is, and of course, since nobody has to go to bed tomorrow night, and we can all just sit here and enjoy, and you're not going to bed tomorrow night, or tonight, rather, what are you going to be doing tomorrow?
Sleeping.
All day?
All day.
You're not going to be watching television?
Not till Sunday night.
And you're going to be sleeping alone?
This is Sunday night. Wait a minute.
You're going to be sleeping alone?
I'm going to be sleeping all day today till I get here tonight.
You didn't answer my question. Alone?
Alone.
We'll be right back.
We've got what you're looking for. TV 20.
KTZO, Stereo TV 20, San Francisco.
I'm going to be giving away copies of this album. It's called Hooked on Themes, and there are themes on here from your favorite television shows, and they were given to us in exchange for promotional consideration. They can be purchased at Tower Records in San Francisco, Gramophone in San Francisco, Record Factory in Redwood City, and Hollywood Connection in San Francisco and Pacifica. And in just a moment, we're going to play for them. Right now, we're going to give away 5 copies of this Hooked on Themes album, including all your favorite TV show themes, to the first 5 callers who can identify this music. Okay, you know what show that's from? Give us the call at 478-5820, 478-5820. The first 5 people who know what show that's from have the album. Tonight's theme music was from Charlie's Angels. Congratulations to our winners. You can see Charlie's Angels every weeknight here on TV 20 at 5. Tomorrow night, another theme and more winners, and I'll be right back.
Welcome back to Night Feed in Las Vegas. I'm John Doté. Well, my producers have asked me to demonstrate to you how I get dressed before we hit Diz's Lounge here at Maryland Parkway from the entertainment capital of the world. And they asked me to show you how I spend an evening by putting on my jewelry and what it takes me, because I do this every single day, and I guess it's stirring up some controversy. So I thought, okay, why not? I'll do it. So they asked to time this, if we could get you guys to time this. I begin my evening by putting on a 22-karat gold, solid that is, 85-foot-long gold chain. Begin timing this, guys, because this is exactly how I begin my evening. When I dress up, I put on my chain just like so. And coming up later on the show is my co-host, my kissing cousin arriving from Portland, Oregon, Charmaine Sarvis. And my other co-host, Michelle Renee, is asleep still, so we don't want to wake her up. I'll have to talk to her and find out exactly why she's asleep. Anyway, this is what's going on. This looks like a Mr. T starter kit, I know. But it isn't, because Mr. T wears a lot more than I do. He's a lot bigger of a guy, too. This is about 12 and a half pounds when I put all 85 feet on. So now we just have to fasten it. Now I'm doing this as quickly as possible. Don't want to spend too much time doing this. And we continue with the other piece. All right, this is getting to be interesting here. Maybe I might set a record. Now this is the longest chain in the world, by the way. Mr. T's are separate pieces. This is all one, divided into 42 and a half. What's half of 85, Jim? 42.5? Exactly, that's it. Okay, so we're getting towards the tail end here of this beautiful 22 solid gold carat French rope chain from France. And we fasten it, and that's what it looks like. Now, to top it off, here is a gold medallion given to me from the famous Caesar's Palace here in Las Vegas, which is located right on the strip. And this is a beautiful piece. And I just lay it right on top of all my other gold chains, just like so. How much time are we into it so far now, Jim? 2 minutes and 30 seconds is what it's taken me so far to put on my jewelry. Now, here's a ring given to me by one of the most famous stars in the world, Liberace. Now, this is an agate stone. It is the largest piece in the world without the grand piano. And as you can see, as an agate stone, it's beautiful in color. It's brown. It has a lot of sparkle to it, a lot of shine. And I wear it right there. And it's very sentimental to me because it was given to me by, of course, a legend, the great Liberace. Also, on that same hand, I wear this 12 oval-shaped diamond gold-clustered ring. And this is a beautiful piece. It's valued at about $5,000. This is valued at about $4,000. And that's my pinky ring. I wear it right there. Next, on that same hand, I wear this ring, which was designed for me for a special occasion. It was a promotional thing that we did for Janet Jackson's record, What Have You Done For Me Lately, which won a couple awards at the St. Francis Hotel in San Francisco. And this reminds me of that occasion. And all these rings definitely have a sentimental value as far as they represented a very important time in my life. And to finish off that hand, I never go anywhere without my good luck piece. This is a Buddha bracelet, which is given to me by my partner, Edith Turner. This is a very beautiful piece. It's surrounded with stones and diamonds, and it's a very real bracelet. And I could think of other places that it would fit, but it fits best right on my wrist. Now for the right hand, let's see, we begin with this $60,000 8.5-carat ring, which I had designed. I had a hit record in the past, and well, with the money, I went out and made an investment. Man, what can I say? This is a beautiful ring. I love it. People love it, and it's a part of me, and it's also sentimental value because of the record. Next to it, I wear this 5 pesos ring. Now, this ring I got in Mexico at about $6,500. It weighs about 49 grams. It has two red rubies, and it's dated 1955, the year that I was born, in case you're keeping track. And it goes right there next to my oval-shaped diamond ring. And next to that, also from Mexico, is this beautiful fire opal ring, and it's orange. And it has, as you can see, the castles on there. Isn't that beautiful? Castle all the way around with the pillars, with diamonds and engraved mounted into it. And it's beautiful. And I wear it right next to my coin ring. And then for my pinky ring to balance it off, I wear this beautiful quartz stone ring, which was once a necklace piece. As you can see, it's got the little hook there. It used to hang from the neck, but I attached the ring to it. And I added diamonds, and the ring is valued at about $15,000. This opal is valued at about $1,500, so you can see the difference. And it is a beautiful pinky ring, and it's shaped like a D for Dote. Yeah, all right. And that just balances out my right hand. It looks like a pair of brass knuckles, but I would never use them that way. And next, my favorite piece of jewelry, this beautiful diamond bracelet. It's got over 400 diamonds in it. This is worth about $60,000. And I saw this sitting in a jewelry store, and my girlfriend thought that I should have it, so she shelled out 60 big ones and bought it for me. And this was purchased in Palo Alto, California. And I wear it on my right wrist. And that's what I look like on my way to an evening in Nightbeat from Las Vegas. We're going to take a commercial break. Charmaine Sarvis is going to join us. Michelle Renee is going to join us. We got a lot of guest stars happening tonight. We got dance contests, album giveaways. And when we come back, while the Rolls Royce is idling, we're going to put on a nice black leather outfit to set the night on fire here at Nightbeat in Las Vegas. I'm John Dote, and we'll be right back, so stick around. Welcome back to Nightbeat in Las Vegas. I'm John Dote. Well, my co-host, Michelle Renee, is still passed out for the evening, but my other co-host, my kissing cousin, Charmaine Sarvis, will be joining us shortly. She's arriving by helicopter from Portland, Oregon. But anyway, we're going to go right now live down to Diz's. The Rolls Royce is warmed up, so let's get rolling. Here we come to you live from the entertainment capital of the world, beautiful Las Vegas. Like when I'm with Janet Jackson, she doesn't dress up and look all famous and everything other than her famous face, you know. But even when I walk down with her and I'm standing next to her, everybody looks at me and stands around me. The media stands around me just because they want to get a picture of this guy wearing, you know, with this guy wearing $100,000 worth of jewelry. That's important to them. It's important to them for their friends to see them standing next to me.
But
so isn't San Francisco a great place to be, though?
San Francisco's great. The Golden Gate Bridge and driving
Bay
over
Bridge,
the hills.
Yes.
The foothills of the headlands. And the
crookedest street. I took my rolls down the crookedest street. I had my rolls all tuned, brakes done and everything. And like a dummy, I went and took it down the crookedest street.
Lombard, 5 miles an hour. You know how that can get, folks.
And I did a big Broadway appearance. I went to Broadway and just appeared in all the clubs and everything. And it was just, we had just a fantastic time.
Really? When you stand on your head, people do look twice.
Yes. But anyway, Dave, I am definitely looking forward to doing some more shows with you.
Well, it's great to have you, John. I'm sure the gang out there loves it, too. The music's out there. You can find it all. Again, here he is, the new album, and A Hero from Zero. And he sure is a hero. And the guy's got a lot of talent, and he's going to go places. So you stick around, watch Free Admission, and you never know who's going to show up here. And remember, you don't have to pay to watch Free Admission, so don't complain, okay? See you in a few minutes.
John, I've known you for a long time. In fact, I first met you when you had a group called Frozen Smoke. And you did a gig for us for the Academy, the Television Academy. And then I had you on a show at the Paramount Theater in Oakland with all the bodybuilders, the biggest bodybuilders in the world, when you did your, it was called, what was the name of the
May I Have This Dance,
right, which is now the theme for This Is San Francisco.
Right. Well, actually, when we did it back in 1976 at the Paramount Theater, that was one of the best shows that I have ever been involved with. And of course, she put the show on, but the cast of stars with Franco Colombo and Nathan LeBlanc and a lot of the top big bodybuilders that were around for a long time that are still around. You see them on Wide World of Sports. It was a great pleasure for me to work with them. And we did the theme, May I Have This Dance. Now that was a disco era, Pete. Now the reggae sound is in. So we've got it done in a reggae sound. And I changed it because I actually wanted to dedicate the song to you. You were the one that really gave me the break back then under a different name. And it was just really neat that we could switch and come back with a whole new sound, different name, and still with your company pushing the record. It's really
Hey, you're a super talent, you know, and your new album, Shake, you know, it's dynamite. You know, you see, we're doing other things too with you too. We're also going to do a thing called The Making of a Record, which we're going to take people right back from the beginning, how it first starts, all the way through in the making of a record. And you know, what's funny is because your first song, Shake, which we did and is on the show, we did it with your full band with horns. I mean, just a big sound.
Yeah.
And yet we were way ahead of ourselves. We weren't ahead of ourselves, but we weren't in today's bag.
Right.
And now you're going back into the studio and what? You're redoing the whole thing?
Well, we're
going
to redo the whole sound because actually I did the sound 3 years ago with Toto. Toto's a well-known group. They walked away with 6 Grammy Awards last year. So now the sound has changed. The new wave is coming back. It's going back to the 60s again because that's really where all the trends and the legends were set in that time. And kids today want to know what happened then in that time because you hear all the time Beatle interviews on radio stations across the country. And kids today, 15 years old, don't know who the Beatles were, so they're bringing that sound back because that was the most successful time period that our industry has ever gone through. Mm-hmm. And I broke out in the later part of the 60s, and so everybody cashed in. It was just the elevator floor. Then the 70s went dead. Well, now we're back to the 80s again, and the sound is changing. So that's why, like on Hooked on Themes, I took the sound of these themes, like the Untouchables that the kids today are not familiar with. Well, now they can hear what the sound was then and what the sound is now, because these shows are all currently airing.
Well, the stuff on it that you did, I mean, it's so classy. And like, we went all out on Hooked on Themes, with even the cover by Alonzo Smith, which his paintings are in the gallery on Sutter Street, and you know his paintings go for like $40,000-$50,000, yeah. And here he put it on your on our cover.
I was very fortunate to have Alonzo do this. I mean, Alonzo's a hell of an artist himself, and he's got the most classiest paintings ever painted by anyone, and I was definitely honored to have his cover on my wish. Thanks to you, this cover of my choice was put on.
And this is volume one. We're also going to be doing one, volume two and three.
Yeah, we'll be doing volume two and three, and on volume two and three, I'll be doing some of the other themes that I've done in the past, like Jaws and Rocky and MASH and Chips. And we'll be redoing them just with the sound of the 80s like we did with Hooked on
And I hope
themes.
We'll be having Alonzo with the covers on. Okay, John, thanks a million.
Thank you, Pete.
And now stay and listen to some of the good hits that John Dote has done on Penthouse Records.
Love it.
Wow.
John here says I'm his biggest fan.
What's that?
That's a beautiful medallion.
Gold medallion, Lincoln head.
Yeah.
Yes, man. You're all out of tune.
Do your impression of Lincoln.
How?
We're going to watch Double Indemnity with Fred McMurray, Barbara Stanwyck, Billy Wilder. Take it away.
In Las Vegas, coming to you from the entertainment capital of the world, fabulous Las Vegas. You're watching Nightbeat. We are the first to break the biggest hits of today and tomorrow, and we've got one of those big hit groups right now on our show. They're called Stir, and they're on Capitol Records. Gentlemen, say hello to your fans in Las Vegas.
What's up, Vegas?
Hello, fans in Las Vegas.
I lost so much money last night.
That's terrible, but you're making more than he's losing, and that's great. Now, you guys have been together for about how long now?
It's been about 6 years, this band.
About 6 years, and where are you originally from?
St. Louis, Missouri.
St. Louis, Missouri. And tell us, how did you get started in the music business?
We started playing for no money, driving 200 miles, and maybe got a free pizza if we were really good that night.
I swear this sounds like a rerun. And how long have you guys been touring on the road, you know, nationally?
For the first record, we toured most of 96 and 97 and took a little break, and we're back at it since the beginning of this year.
And you guys got a new hit record right now called New Beginning, and I'm featuring the video on my show, and we are the first, if not in the country, in Las Vegas to air it. And you're going to see this interview on UPN Channel 25 Thursday at 5 a.m. Now, just for our groups out there that are looking to make a start, can you give us a little background on how new groups, up-and-coming groups, can get a start?
Get in the van. Drive, 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 and play your butt off. That's it. That's the only advice I have. Write good songs.
That's right. That's the key, writing good songs. And who writes the songs in the band?
Andy writes probably majority of the songs, and Kevin and I contribute for a couple on the record.
And, you know, I was talking earlier with you guys, power trios in the 60s, the 70s, the 80s, like the Hendrix Experience, like the Cream. There's not too many of those groups around anymore, and now here you guys are back, and it takes a hell of an arrangement and good talent to just narrow a band down to three guys and create a sound and a hit record. How do you guys do it?
Well, we like to think that we make a lot of noise for three guys, and Andy and I both play keyboards and our guitars at the same time. Brad plays, he's got a sampling machine and drums and some electronics back there, and we just go for it. It's a new thing every night. You never know what's going to happen.
And you guys all collaborate on doing the writing, and what about vocals and stuff like that?
Yeah, I do some background vocals live, but on the record we all do a little background singing.
Do you miss being back in St. Louis? How do you like Las Vegas?
Oh, we love it here. Absolutely. I'd love to spend some more time. Unfortunately, we have to fly to Houston tonight, but yeah.
Well, you might save some money doing that.
Exactly. I'd be up on top of that thing doing the thing.
Right, right.
I did it like 8 times in a row.
So you're here in Vegas for how long?
About 6 more hours, I think.
So how long have you been here now?
About 3 hours.
About 3 hours. Have you guys had any sleep?
No.
No sleep. So, and what's your schedule like? Now, where are you guys going this summer? I know you're touring. Where are you guys going from here?
After we finish up 2 weeks with Terrain, we do about 2 weeks in the southeast with Creed and Seven Dust. And then we go out in June with Three Doors Down.
That's great, because Creed's one of the groups that we also were the first to play here. And are you married?
Absolutely.
Absolutely. Do you have children?
One son.
Do they travel with you?
Not at this point, but maybe someday. He's going to be my roadie.
He's going to be your roadie. Don't bring him to Vegas. You might lose some money, really. But this is the entertainment capital of the world, and these guys are superstars all over the world. You can buy their records here in Vegas and anywhere you go. Tune into the radio stations. You can hear them, but most of all, tune into my show because you can see them right here live like I did. Also, be sure to tune in to www.nightbeatinlasvegas.com. They will be featured on our website, and you can see them there just as well. We're going to go right now and take a break, and after this, we're going to have the luxury of going backstage with these superstars and see how they perform live. And gentlemen, I really would like to thank you for being on my show.
Thank you.
Superstar, definitely. Thank you.
Thank you for having us.
Thank you, and we'll be right back with more of Night Beat in Las Vegas. Welcome to Night Beat in Las Vegas Rock and Roll Review with John Tote, coming to you from the entertainment capital of the world, fabulous Las Vegas. Playing you the biggest hits of today and tomorrow from UPN Channel 25 KCNG. And we're commercial free, and we're going to kick things off right in the ass with Britney Spears. And Oops, I Did It Again, a brand new record. But first, let's take you to the exclusive interview with Britney.
So much fun, so amazing. I've learned so much and met so many incredibly talented, wonderful, sweet people. But if I had to boil it down, I would probably say the MTV Europe Awards. That was the first award show that I went to where I won awards and everything.
And the winner is Britney Spears!
It was so exciting. I met Whitney Houston there, Mariah Carey there. I mean, seriously, they're like my idols I've looked up to vocally all my life, and just meeting them was just so incredible. And the Billboard Awards as well, just being able to perform amongst people, celebrities that I've idolized and looked up to all my life, is so amazing. I knew last year that I was going to be performing for the Grammys pretty much, so just the thought of that is so exciting. So probably the award shows and my birthday party when I turned 18, that was a lot of fun too, because all of my friends from back in Louisiana, they came up and they got to spend it with me, and it was really cool because I'm not overpressed and everything, but I'm used to, you know, being taken, my photograph being taken and everything. So to see the joy in their faces, having their picture taken, is so cool. You know, that's really sweet. So
this is a story about a girl named Lucky.
We're off to the studio right now to record.
Bye. Early morning, she wakes up. Knock, knock, knock on the door. It's time for makeup.
As I've been traveling and everything, I've been seeing a lot of celebrities, and I kind of scope out the people that they're traveling with. Like Felicia, she travels with me. I don't know what I would do without her, seriously. Her spirit is so wonderful, so it's really nice to have someone there. Like if I'm down or something, if I'm sad one day, she's there to just lift my spirits up, you know. Anything different for this album. I think I'm just really growing up as a person And so that's just gonna, it just kind of flows with it. You know, I'm not gonna change something dramatically from what I did a long time ago. You know, I'm just gonna be me and, you know, hope everything works out.
I love to hear you say that you love me with words so sweet.
He just goes,
I'm a husband.
This is Steve Lund. He's my A&R guy. I've been with him for like a year and a half now. But he's not the normal A&R guy. He really gets involved with the music side of things. So actually, right now, we're just working on the song that Diane Warren wrote. If you make some noise, we're going to have to kick you out, all right?
Tell him it's history.
Your history, man. I love to hear you say that you love me. That was way too low, so I'm sorry. I love to hear you. That was so low. Okay. Got the giggles.
I think we're so comfortable together because we've, you know, ever since Brittany first came up to the company, you know, we've known each other so from the age of 15, when she first, well, you were 15 when you first came to the company as a nervous 15-year-old who came into our A&R offices to sing a cappella for us. And she was so nervous. In fact, I've told you this before. She was standing there, she was singing, and her eyes were rolling back in her head, and I thought it was just the way she sang. I said, oh, this is going to look great on a video. And I realized it was only because she was about to pass out. She was so nervous.
I was really, really nervous. It was so intimidating because they were having their A&R meeting, and I walked in, and they were all sitting around this big table, and there was just silence. And I'm used to performing in front of big crowds and everything, and I went in there just staring at me. Like, oh, God. And they started asking me all these questions. It was the most nerve-wracking thing I've ever, actually, probably the most nervous I've ever been in my life. It's not laughing.
You're watching Night Beat in Las Vegas Rock and Roll Review with Britney Spears.
So composed in everything she does and so in control of things around her that now when I think back at this 15-year-old and with her eyes rolling around in her head like a pinball machine, it doesn't seem like her at all. But even at that point, it was obvious of her star quality.
There's a girl in the mirror. You know, it all boils down to talent and believing in yourself and then having people around you support you and help you out, you know, and believe in you as well. And I think if I do that, I'll be okay.
What we tried to do on the record is to definitely cover all the bases with all the people who are so in love with her right now. You know, we're doing some songs that are just very sweet and personal. And we're trying to capture her personality. I mean, that's what Britney is. That's why she's a star. It's the personality. It's this. That's what comes off the TV screen.
There's the girl in my mirror is crying tonight. I have a little bit more confidence. And in the studio, right before I had just turned 16 when I got signed to the record label, and I was new at the whole game, you know. I mean, even in dance class and making a video, I didn't know anything. So when I came to the studio, I really kind of let other people not tell me what to do, but help me out. And I think if you were, not because I'm young, but I think if you were 28, you would have done the same thing. You know, it's just something that I had to experience and grow with. I don't want to just be some singer who just sings a song to sing it, you know. I think you sing it with feeling, and when you do that and you put your all into it, you connect with that person. You know, that's really important to me.
We're trying to make every song count. Every song is for a specific part of her audience, for instance. You know, I mean, there's songs on there for a young female audience that she's not going to forget just because there's a male audience out there that thinks she's a babe.
I think this album will definitely get me a wider audience. I definitely do, because just the words and the material and the tracks, they're just a little bit more mature and a little bit more adult. And I think when you're fans, when you do have fans and they like you, they want you to succeed and they will grow with you.
We were well aware that when we signed Britney that this was going to be bigger than just a teen thing, you know, and we don't want it to be just a teen thing. That's where it starts. And the songs, it's always down to the songs. If the songs are good enough, then it goes across everybody, don't you think?
Well, if I hear a demo of the song, I pretty much know if I like it. But then it's a matter of me getting into the studio and me just feeling the song and me, like you said, me just putting my personality into it and taking over the song. Actually, when I was on tour, I was always writing in my head and singing melodies in my head. And it was kind of intimidating at first because I was working with the most amazing songwriters in the world and I didn't want to sing a melody to them and then be like, well, it's not that great. So,
that I started, like, all my best stuff that I would write, I would keep in my journal. I would call him up and, do you like this? Does this sound okay? Or leave it on his voicemail at home, answer machine at home, and I would leave it. And he would be like, yeah, it's cool, and we'd see what we could do with it. So, and the more and more I did it, the better I got. So, and then one of the songs that's going to be on the album, so I'm excited. Actually, I just got finished hearing the first single. Oops, I did it again. And I'm so happy about it. It's incredible. It's amazing. And I think it's better than Baby One More Time. Hopefully everyone else will think it's better as well. So we'll see.
You're watching Night Beat in Las Vegas, Rock and Roll Review with John Doté, showing you for the first time anywhere in the world the exclusive interview with Britney Spears right here from UPN Channel 25.
That's put around it. She does, you know, comes up with the concepts for the live shows and the videos and everything. I mean, she's a fully involved artist.
Most of the videos, like Baby One More Time, that was my idea. And actually, the video that's probably going to be for the next album, the first single, will be my idea. Important to me for each performance that I do to be just amazing and to be different from the last. So, and it's really hard because I'm so busy and I'm doing promotional stuff and I'm recording to fit in the time to have an amazing performance and to have rehearsal. I mean, for instance, my MTV Europe performance, I was recording in Sweden the week before I went to the award show. I had like one day of rehearsal. So I had a videotape every night after I would finish recording. I'd put the videotape in and I would learn the routine off a videotape. I was driving myself crazy. I was delirious. But it was so worth it. It was so worth it. When I went on stage, I knew what I was doing and I felt really confident with it. And the results were amazing and everyone's like, oh my God, you know, your performance was so happy and that means so much to me and it's worth it. It's really weird because when I was touring, I mean, one night I would have just like all college guys out in the audience and they'd be screaming my name. I was like, oh Lordy. And then one night I would have younger kids and then sometimes I have teenagers. But it was just really cool, no matter what the audience was, they were always watching me on stage and these big smiles on their faces, knowing all the words to my songs. And that's so flattering. You know, it's so flattering and overwhelming to know that they dig me enough to get their little spending money and go buy my CD. You know, that means a lot to me.
The first to play the biggest hits of today and tomorrow right here on Night Beat from UPN Channel 25. I am John Doté with my rock and roll review. And that was Tracy Spencer. And right now we're going to stay with Capitol Records and take you back to Meredith Brooks and a brand new release called Bitch, which it is. Welcome to Night Beat. I am John Doté with another edition of playing you the biggest hits of today and tomorrow. We're going to kick things off with a brand new release heard for the first time right here. It's by Robbie Williams, and that record's called Angels, and this is the U.S. version from Capitol Records. Get a hold of me and stay tuned, because for more information about, we are going on the World Wide Web, all around the world, bringing you the biggest hits of today and tomorrow, including up-and-coming artists. Right now, let's get into Nothing Records. Oh, that's incredible stuff, especially the president of Capitol Records, Roy Lott, coming out and giving her a plug on her record. That just isn't seen too many times. That doesn't happen too often. But Tara McLean, congratulations on a great career, on a great record. It's number one here, and we'll keep you on top as long as we can. Also, thanks to Stir and New Beginning. Both acts are on Capitol Records, and both records are out in the stores, and you can buy them now. Let's get funky. It's early in the morning, Las Vegas. Wake up, let's party from the 24-hour city. If you would like to get a hold of me, you can do so by calling 638-6535. That's 638-6535. And if you're an up-and-coming artist and you're unsigned and you'd like to be featured on our show, get a hold of me. We will also be, by the time you see this, on www.nightbeatinlasvegas.com, featuring the up-and-coming artists from all over the country and all over the world, right here from Night Beat. If I'm good enough to pick the hits for the majors, I'm certainly good enough to pick the hit station to do it on, and that's UPN Channel 25. And with time remaining here, we're going to switch over to Geffen Records because we've got a couple of minutes left, and we're going to do some Folk Implosion free to go right here. Let's do it. Good morning, Las Vegas. I am John Dote coming to you from Night Beat in Las Vegas Rock and Roll Review Room right here at Celebrity Studio. It was a great weekend last 4th of July. Cottonmouth Kings showed up at the House of Blues and tore the house down. As we promised, we've got that interview, but right now, let's go to their video, Dog's Life.